Hello, and welcome back to BCTV. I'm Braden Charlton.
And I'm Lindsay Ballman.
With recent student protests and walkouts over gun control, we decided to see what students at Carroll think and know about this controversial issue. Matthew Kelly has a story.
Why do you support the Second Amendment?
Because I don't think guns are the issue. I think it's the people that have them that are the issue.
I believe that everyone should be allowed to have guns because if they're illegal, I mean, people still have them, so still use them, so we should all be allowed to have guns.
Do you believe that if we have gun control laws, criminals will follow those laws?
No.
Can I get your opinions on gun control and what your view is?
I think at a bare minimum, we should have lawmakers try to ban automatics, bump stocks, and magazines.
Some people suggest arming the teachers in order to prevent mass shootings at schools. How do you feel about that?
I feel like certain designated teachers should have access to guns.
Okay, so would you give me a few at Carroll?
Mr. Sunquist, Coach Carey.
Do you believe there should be any age restrictions on these weapons?
One of the things that really struck me was that you can buy an automatic rifle at 18, but you have to wait until you're 21 to buy a handgun. So for me, definitely waiting until 21 when you're considered a legal kind of where you get all of the rights that you do, like drinking, for instance, it might be better to wait till 21 till you can buy that automatic weapon. That's my hope, is that the age restriction is moved up.
How do you feel about this?
Over half of them don't even know how to turn on the projector, so.
Dallas, what is your view on gun control?
I think there needs to be more gun control than there is now because I don't feel like there's enough. So I think there should be more background checks and more. Well, definitely the ban of automatic weapons, because that is a major problem in our country today, because a lot of the mass shootings we had are with automatic weapons such as AR-15s and AK-47s, which are military-style weapons. They're not used for anything else besides that.
How about you, Britt?
I know Mr. Skaggs would shoot at like a gang member, so probably not him.
I did not create this segment to start a fight, but to start a little discussion between students. And I'd like to ask students not to give anybody in this video a hard time about their opinions. Everyone is entitled to them, and I would like to thank everybody in this video for voicing those opinions. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Matt.
Choir and band had their contest concert on April 5th. They'll perform the same pieces at the state contest on the 18th. Good luck, Eagles.
Mr. Pinkerton's Physics 2 classes are breaking toothpick bridges today, so wish them luck.
Now we have the latest edition of Lunchroom Interviews with Alex Owens. Take it away.
What is the worst thing to ever happen to you?
When I was about 2 years old, I fell out of a two-story window, so, you know, that's fun. Almost dying's real fun.
Okay, Mr. Rock,
yes.
So all tuna is fish, but are all fish tuna?
I'm gonna go with no on that. Not everybody can, all eagles are birds, but golden eagles are higher than normal eagles. Just ask Maze.
Joel, what is the capital of Canada?
Toronto.
Are you sure?
No, I'm not at all.
Andrew, what is the capital of Canada?
Toronto.
Are you sure?
Maybe.
Hey Ashton, what's the capital of Canada?
Montreal.
So John, how was your morning?
I got a ticket this morning, going 80 and a 55.
I got your interview for you. You want some Swedish fish, dog? Hey,
Thanks, Alex.
Prom is coming up, and to prepare, we teamed up with the Flyer for the first ever Bishop Carroll Promposal Dating Game, 2018 edition. Jake Campbell is your host. Over to you, Jake.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the first official episode of Burning Love, Prom Edition. I'm your host, Jake Campbell. Now, before I get into the nitty-gritty of how the game is played, let us first meet our lovely bachelorette, Claire Gunner. Oh my goodness. Claire, tell us something about yourself.
Every Thursday morning, I do water aerobics with 70-year-old women.
Absolutely fantastic. All right, everyone, so this is how the game works. I am going to be asking questions to our lovely, strapping young bachelors, and Claire will be deciding which one of their answers is the best. Now, after each one of the questions have been asked and answered, Miss Gunner will be deciding which one of these gentlemen she will be taking to prom with her. All right, but there is a little bit of a catch. So in order to maintain the anonymity of our bachelors, we are going to be having them do a little bit of helium as they answer their questions. So is everyone familiar with how the game is played? Wonderful. All right, let us begin. First question, what is your ideal first date? And this is gonna go to bachelor number one.
My ideal first date is going to a very nice vegetarian restaurant.
My ideal first date would be taking her to a nice day at Cheney Lake.
My ideal first date would be dinner and a movie.
Lock and Alyssa, which one of those bachelors did you think had the best answer?
I'm gonna have to go with contestant number two.
Contestant number two, congratulations. Next question, bachelor number one, what is your favorite TV show?
Working Housewives.
The Bachelorette.
How I Met Your Mother.
Which one of those bachelors do you think had the best answer?
Bachelor three.
Bachelor number three, great job, great job. I can feel it, I can sense it. Sparks and love is in the air. Next question, bachelor number one, what is your favorite restaurant?
Olive Garden.
McDonald's.
Lotus Leaf Cafe, the vegan restaurant.
Lotus Leaf Cafe, the vegan restaurant. All right, Ms. Gunner, which one of their answers was the best?
Definitely number three.
Definitely number three, vegan restaurant, oof. All right, bachelors, next question. What is your favorite song?
Well, I like to listen to the Gregorian chant.
Gregorian chant, everyone's favorite.
I'd have to say the Macarena.
I'd have to say Gasolina.
Gasolina. Absolutely wonderful. How cultured. All right, Claire, what do you think?
You know, I can get down to all three, but definitely contestant number two.
Definitely contestant number two. Excellent job. Excellent job. A very wholesome answer indeed, bachelor number three. All right, Claire, the contestants have answered all their questions. What is your opinion?
You know, this is probably the hardest decision I've ever had to make, but I'm gonna go with...
Pump your brakes there, Claire. We're gonna be right back with the final verdict, so make sure to stick around.
Prom is on the 21st at the Cotillion. Doors open at 8:30 and tickets are $20. After prom will follow when tickets are 10. Students will need to sign permission slips to take part in the inflatables.
We are all anxiously awaiting for the Eagle Cup day on the 23rd.
Speaking of which, we have the current Eagle Cup standings.
Teresa Lasue is in first place with 548 points, with Max Colby in second with 516 points.
And Philip Neary is in third with 464 points. Now we have Trevor with the spring sports update.
And afterwards, we have Camera Via delivering the announcements.
Boys track and field won both Andale and Valley Center, with girls taking third. Both teams will be competing at pre-state this weekend at Wichita State. Golf placed second at Clapp Golf Course this Monday. Swim has a 3-1 record and will swim at Blue Valley Southwest tomorrow. Trap shooting has resumed for the spring season. Updates will be posted on Saturday. Soccer has a 5-1 record, including a second place finish at the Titan Classic. Tennis finished 6th at the Arc City Invitational. Softball has an 8-0 record, but that does not include yesterday's game at Mays. Baseball remains undefeated and will play tonight at West Urban Adams Field. This game is also for Eagle Cup. That's all for sports. Back to you guys.
Today is a green extended schedule with chicken tenders and mashed potatoes as today's lunch. For students taking AP Biology next year, there's a meeting April 16th at 325 or April 17th at 730 in room 211. The closing celebration for God Squad is the following Wednesday, April 18th from 6 to 8 p.m. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Back to Jake with the final verdict of the dating game.
We are going to find out which one of these three strapping young men Claire has decided to go to prom with. Claire, what is your final decision?
You know, this has really been hard to think about, but bachelor number three.
Bachelor number three, and so it is. And so it is. There you go. Excellent. Something to give her. Oh, yeah, there you go. Oh. Shake hands, hug. I don't know what you do. All right, absolutely. Absolutely wonderful. It looks like the other confessions are a little salty, but that's all right. They'll get over it because prom is on April 21st. Check out this hot couple on the dance floor. Be there, be square. Thank you all so much for watching. Back to you.